Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our spring concert, a celebration of women in choral music. In honor of Women's History Month, tonight you will hear songs written by female composers, lyrics written by female poets, songs that uplift women, and also some student testimonials about women who have empowered them in their lives. The Timberwolf Chorus will be performing three selections for you tonight. Our first number, As Vesta Was from Latmos Hill Descending, comes from a collection of madrigals written in 1601 to honor Queen Elizabeth I. This will be followed by Eric Essenwald's setting of Only in Sleep, featuring Jeroen Cirkel and Annalisa Cradle on the solos. Our last piece will be Fire, written by the Canadian composer, Katarina Ginn.
Thank you. achievements of women in music, the treble chorus will be singing a medley of one of the most notable female singers of all time, the Queen of Soul, Aretha Franklin.
Thank you. share about some women who inspire us. The woman who empowers me is Captain Marvel. She empowers me because of her determination and that she always gets up no matter how much she's knocked down. She knows that she doesn't have to prove anything to anyone in order to believe in herself.
One of the most inspirational women in my life is my mother. She has given me the best advice through her life experiences and does the best of her ability to supply me with everything I need. I never shared my true thoughts or feelings with anyone until my mother said that it was okay to cry and let people into my life. Despite the hardship she faces herself, she still puts on a smile and holds her head strong. For that reason, I value her as one of the most powerful women in my life.
The next three songs are a collaboration between the soprano alto choir, tenor bass choir, and treble chorus. Our first song is No Mirrors in My Nana's House by Yasai Barnwell. This will be followed by Javier Busto's Setting of Ave Maria, and our last piece is Honor the Earth, written by the Australian composer Sarah Hawkins.
There were no mirrors in my nana's house, no mirrors in my In the next piece, the tenors and basses of the Clovis Choir program will sing American classic, Take Me Out to the Ballgame. Although the song is originally associated with baseball games around the world, it wasn't commonly known until a female organist played at the Chicago White Sox games. This female organist, Nancy Frust, played it so well, the sportscaster Harry Carey could not help but sing along, and that is how this song became a baseball tradition.
Contribute to our celebration of women by singing the music standard, The Lady is a Tramp. In this song, the lyrics describe a strong, independent woman who is not interested in following the social norms of the elite. She doesn't like playing craps, she doesn't like wearing furs and pearls. Instead, she likes the free fresh air and the carefree life. As a result, the elite dismiss her and call her a tramp. Does she care? Not a bit.
Thank you. likes the theater, but she never comes late.
She never bothers to people she hates. That's why the lady is a tramp.
She doesn't like crap games with barons and earls.
Won't go to Harlem.
She helped me with so much. She supported me when I was in dance, when I was in Girl Scouts. When I was learning to write, she was always there to help guide and teach me. She raised 5 kids, trained horses, worked in a hospital, and helped so many other people outside of those things. Even though she isn't here with me anymore, she still helps me in any situation I get stuck in. When I'm down, I just think about something she used to say or do, and it always helps me. My mom is my empowering woman and my rock.
A female that inspires me is Megan Trainor. When I was younger, I used to get picked on by my brothers, which caused me to be more to myself. Listening to her music showed me that I am great who I am, and it helped me to get out of my comfort zone. I understand that her music was meant more for women, but I believe that if you interpret the song your own way, it could apply to anyone in general.
When my dad was my age, my grandmother suffered a stroke. The doctor said she had a brain tumor, but after performing surgery, they found there was no tumor. As her mysterious condition worsened, she couldn't walk or talk. She was glued to her hospital bed, and she was forced to give up her store. But over time, through perseverance, physical therapy, and the help of her family, she was able to walk, she was able to talk, and when I was born, she even learned to speak English. Today, she runs a small clothing business and continues to care for me and her family. I love you, Abuelita. Thank you for always being strong.
About one of the most famous women in American history and Kathy McGuire's arrangement of Harriet Tubman. Thank you.